and Rowdy.
Thanks, Al, and there is a very good chance that it will. In fact, the Americans are the huge favorites here in the second of the three relays. You probably witnessed the incredible shorter distance one, the 4x100. This is the 800-meter freestyle relay, and Michael Phelps, just about 54 minutes from when he touched for Olympic gold in the 200 fly, is back in the pool and on the blocks to lead off the relay. Already the greatest Olympic champion in history by virtue of that 10th Olympic gold he picked up earlier in the night, and now after number 11, and unless something crazy happens, Rowdy, he's gonna get it.
Well, no question, he has to have safe takeoffs, the rest of these kids do. And you might be asking yourself, why are they leading off with Michael Phelps? Why not anchor this relay with your best swimmer? Well, the coaches decided to put him in front and say, I'm going to put you guys out in front. Let's see what you can do now. And he asked to do this. He likes to get this team off to a good lead.
10th of 17 swims for Phelps. Put up a time at the Olympic trials in Omaha to help avert any kind of controversy as far as to his ability to swim this 100-meter distance. And look at Phelps in the 100 meters. Ahead of that world record line there. That again is a world record that we expect to just be smashed.
Yeah, once again, note that that world record line is for the relay. He was a couple tenths of a second off his own world record, his individual world record, which you can break on the leadoff leg of a relay. But look at the room that he's going to be able to give to the Americans here coming up.
Michael Phelps building a huge lead for the United States. Getting next in the pool is his good friend, American teammate Ryan Lochte, who finished with the bronze behind Phelps in the 400 IM, a race that Phelps had tremendous respect for as Lochte is concerned. Lochte, who was suffering afterwards, he said, from some intestinal problems, did not swim a very good race, but feeling a little better as he gets into the pool. And look how far they are ahead of the world record line there as Phelps turns in a great time.
Yeah, that's a really solid time. Remember, coming back a little over 50 minutes after that 200 butterfly. It's the second fastest in history. Brilliant time. Once again, another guy that only has broken 44. He's the only one under 144. A great leadoff for the United States.
Americans have a 2.5-second lead over Russia. So here is Lochte, who will also challenge another American star in the 200 back distance. And he shares the world record with Aaron Pearsall, who's already got a gold medal in the 100 back. So Lochte getting ready to finish up here. Mark just lengthens the lead here.
Well, they are about 9 seconds ahead of world record pace. That's how far out in front these guys are so early on. This is not going to be the thrill ride that we might have seen in the 400 free relay, but if you like watching world records and you like watching Michael Phelps win 11 gold medals, don't go anywhere.
Lochte, three-time world champion.
And he's just now starting to feel better, Dan. You know, that stomach virus he had really affected him. You can see Michael starting to spur him on, and they're not even halfway.
World record line can't keep up with the Americans. And getting ready to go will be Ricky Behrens. He'll be a junior at Texas. And he earned a spot with this big three, Phelps, Ryan Lochte, and Peter Vanderkay, who will anchor by virtue of his preliminary swim. And that was a bit of a decision the coaches had to make over Cleet Keller, who was the guy that held off Ian Thorpe 4 years ago for American gold.
Well, I got a little ahead of myself. I said 9 seconds. I can't keep track of how fast these guys are going. And now they're about 3.5 seconds of under world record pace. He was 144. Ryan Lochte was that. He went 145.8 when they broke the world record in Melbourne a year ago. First, so he was much better.
First-time Olympian Ricky Behrens in the pool. What a big moment for him, Rowdy, swimming with the big guns here, Lochte, Phelps, and Vanderkay, and knowing that a gold medal is in his sight.
Well, this is a tough decision, or was a tough decision for the American coaches, because Cleet Keller in the prelims went about the same time, about a tenth of a second slower than Ricky Behrens, but a lot of people thought maybe Clint Keller should be on the relay because he's been a big part of that relay for so long. But this is a great chance, as you said, for this youngster to become a part of history.
So exciting, that 400 free relay. But this 800 free relay is the oldest relay on the men's side. It began back in 1908. It's been contested some 22 times. The U.S. competing in it 21 times. They've won a medal every single time they've competed in it. And the U.S. winning the event, taking gold 14 times of the 22. And Ricky Behrens continuing to lengthen that lead for the Americans as Peter Vanderkay gets ready to go in. Phelps's training mate at the University of Michigan and Club Wolverine. In goes PVK, as they like to call him. He's got his whole family here, his three brothers, who all swim for the University of Michigan. It is a Ann Arbor family affair for Peter Vanderkay and his brothers.
Pretty good split for Ricky Behrens, 146.2. A little bit slower than he went in prelims, but it doesn't really matter. I think my mom could probably anchor this relay. They could break the world record. Look at the time now. 7:03.24 is the world record. Let's see if they can break 7 minutes. Wouldn't that be something?
Trying to become the first team to get under the seven-minute mark. Phelps keeping a close eye on all the splits. There's Ryan Lochte cheering Vanderkay in as well. Vanderkay in his second Olympics. Qualified in three individual events here and earlier won his first individual medal when he took bronze behind Michael Phelps and company in the 200 free. Way ahead of the world record line. So Phelps looking for career Olympic gold number 11.
Wow, such a complete dominating performance. I mean, the camera has to pan back just to get everybody else in the picture.
So Peter Vanderkay coming home. Michael Phelps about ready to add to his incredible Olympic gold total. Keep it perfect here at these Beijing Games. Not only with Olympic gold, but with world records in each and every one of them. The first ever. Under 7 minutes, the Americans of the 800 free. Perfect 5 for 5 in Beijing is Phelps. All of them world records.
Wow. Wow. .144 on the end for PVK. Now they can start dancing.
Broke the world record by 5 seconds. And we have been reluctant to talk about this before now. But definitely in view now for Phelps. Mark Spitz's record of 7 Olympic golds, all in world record, coming back in 72. So Phelps runs the table. He'll surpass Spitz with the greatest single Olympic Games performance in history. Already with the most golds in Olympic history. Another world record for the United States in Michael Phelps. Russia was second. Australia was third. And the 13 career Olympic medals now for Phelps puts him past Jenny Thompson as the most decorated swimmer in Olympic history. Let's send you back to Al Trotwig and gymnastics. Another